मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द अनदर वीडियो ऑफ मॉरल साइंस क्लास 6। एंड टुडे आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू द चैप्टर नंबर 7 ऑफ मॉरल साइंस। चैप्टर नंबर 7 और चैप्टर नेम इज प्रॉपर यूज ऑफ टाइम। This chapter, I will teach you how to utilize your time in proper way. Basically, we are not using our time properly, okay? Sometime we started to play and we continue playing. Sometime we started sleeping and continuously we sleep. So, in such examples, we just only wasting our time, okay? And at last, when our examination drawing near, then we feel, you know, horrified by this fact that we did not utilize our time properly. In this story, in this chapter, I have taken the example of Dinesh. He is a student and he involved in such activities like playing, teaching, reading, swimming, you know, gaming also. And in this video we will see that how he used his time. See, in this video we will discuss that how, what kind of problems Dinesh faced and how he overcame from these problems. Okay, so as we know that Dinesh had many hobbies, and students, you know the meaning of hobby. Hobby is a pastime which a person do for his free time, for his free time. And there are a lot of hobbies like music, like gardening, like reading, like dancing, like swimming, and many more things. Many of you play video games on your mobile. Many of you went to swimming classes. Many of you goes to dancing classes. And many of you, you know, playing cricket, playing hockey, playing kabaddi. And there are so many games you used to play. Okay. So these are called hobbies which a person do in his or her free time. Okay. So let's talk about this topic. As we know that Dinesh had many hobbies and he also wanted to do well in his studies. It means that he is doing well in his studies. He is good in studies. He is, you know, position holder also. He loved to play tennis and went for swimming too. He had so many indoor or outdoor activities. He used to go for tennis practice in the morning. For that he had to catch an early bus. Then he would come back home and he used to take bath. And after bathing and having breakfast, then he went to school. In the afternoon, he came back from school and then there were math tutions, swimming classes and guitar lessons on alternate days. Alternate days means today swimming classes, tomorrow guitar lessons, and the day after another music classes. So he used to involve in such kind of activities. Students, it is good to keep yourself involved in such kind of activities, but in involving, in merging in such activities, we also forget to utilize, to make a timetable, and we involve in such a way that we lose our track that what we are supposed to do in our life. We involve in each and every activities in a hodgepodge way. You know, hodgepodge means not in clear way. We have to involve in swimming, we have to involve in outdoor activities to make ourselves fit, we have to involve in dancing classes, we have to involve in computer classes, but is this the proper use? There are certain times for certain activities. For example, if you are involving in your studies, so better you should study in your time. Okay, don't involve in swimming, don't involve in dancing classes. These are, you know, free time activities. For example, in summer vacation, for example, in winter vacation, you have to take part in such activities, but not in the study time. Because in a study time, if you involve in such activities, you will move on from the track of your study. Okay, and your grading will also suffer from that way. So better if you are in studies, so you should pay proper attention to your studies. So students, he used to involve in such activities in alternate days. He also loved to play with his friends and to watch television and to play games on the computer. It means he performed his daily routine like a machine. He had to involve in such kind of activity. That is way. So what kind of problems he had to face, we will go through this. And on top of that, completed his homework. He had to complete his homework finally. Oh, what a handful for a child. What a misery for a, you know, child of 6th standard, who was just studying in 6th standard, and he has to follow such routine, such hectic schedule. There were days when he could not get time to do his homework, and the result and the consequences of such activities are he has to forget his work, his homework, what he are supposed to complete. Even he could not get the time to complete his homework also. His teacher would scold him. Sometimes he could not complete work given in tuition. He was unable to complete work in tuition because due to this hectic schedule, he became so tired that he did not pay attention. He did not pay attention properly to his homework, to his tuition work in the same manner. So then his mother and his tutor scolded him. Sometimes he got so busy playing with his friends. He used to play with his friends that he missed his math tuition. And sometimes he, you know, used to forget his tuition classes just because of involvement in his friend. One day he became so tired that his body refused to move. His body refused to move from here to there. And when he woke up in the morning, he went off to sleep. He again slept. When he got up, it was already past his school time. It means he became so late in the morning that he missed his school bus on that day. So students, this is the result of involving in many activities in a single time. His mother scolded him again for this purpose. You know, when you miss your rickshaw, when you miss your auto, when you miss your school van, then your mother supposed to scold you for this purpose. So Dinesh is being scolded for this purpose. So finally, at last, Dinesh felt really sad. He became sad. He remained sad in his house, and he did not do it intentionally. We all know that he is good in study, he is doing well in study, but his gradings are suffering. His gradings are suffering, but he did not do it, you know, deliberately. He just felt too tired to get up that day. In the evening, when his relative, his grandmother see this, she came to, you know, visit them. Dinesh was very fond of his granny, like grandmother. He is very fond of to visit his granny. He asked her, "Nani, can you help me?" His grandmother asked, "Which kind of help you are, you know, you are asking for me? I want to do so many things." Then he told his problem to her, that he used to involve in so many things, but he did not have enough time to complete them, to fulfill them, to do them. So his grandmother sat with him and asked him to make a timetable, to make a list of all the things, that when you are supposed to do particular things and when you are supposed to do the other things. She asked him to make a list for all your, you know, activities. They divided the list into three parts. They have decided to bifurcate the work in three different ways. The first part had things which he had to do every day. In first part of the list, he had to do the things which he had to perform in every day. The second list had those things which he had to do during weekends only. In other list, he has to maintain the record of those things which he had to perform on weekends only. And the third list had those things which he liked to do when he got bored. For it means to remove his boredom. That thing he used to do will be in the third list. Okay. So in such a way, Dinesh had to prepare three different lists. First thing, he had to write the things which he had to do every day. In second list, he had to do the things in weekends. And in third list, he had to write the things which he supposed to do to remove his boredom for his entertainment purpose only. Okay. So Dinesh listed all his jobs under these three lists. Now homework, getting things ready for school, tennis and swimming practice, tuition, polishing shoes and doing some household jobs went into the first list. In his first list, Dinesh mentioned the things which he had to do on priority basis, like homework, like getting things ready to school, or tennis practice, or swimming practice, and tuition and polishing shoes and other household jobs. Okay, reading storybooks, playing with friends, cleaning bookshelves, watching television, and doing extra study went into the second list. And in third list, painting, playing video games, watching movies, picnics, these things were mentioned in the third list. Now grandmother said to Dinesh, now you see Dinesh, after preparing this list, Dinesh asked his granny to, you know, go through that list. Then granny explained him the things why he said to him to prepare those lists. What is the purpose to preparing such lists? According to granny, he want to tell him to perform the things according to the priority. Priorities means giving importance. Means what is important and what is not important. Now see, he said that he could make his timetable accordingly. Make two timetables. One for the school days timetable and second for the weekends timetable. Then follow them properly. Now, Dinesh used to do such things. You know, students, priority means giving importance to such things which is very important, which is basically important in our life. Okay, so now Dinesh has started to follow such timetable, and you know, when he had started to follow the timetables, now his grading have been improved and he is doing well in each and every sectors of his life. He also makes sure that he did not put too many activities in them, otherwise he may not be able to follow them. His grandmother asks him to follow the timetable. Okay, so the two of them made a timetable for Dinesh. The next day Dinesh followed the timetable completely. This went on for a week. By the end of the week, he found that nobody scolded him and he was not feeling tired either. You know what happened with him? Because he started to follow those lists which he had made for him. Now, no more issues with Dinesh, and everyone was happy with him, and he was also happy and satisfied. So the conclusion of this chapter is, if we students are supposed to, you know, utilize our time, we have to know that how we can use the proper, we can make our time properly used. Okay, we should not waste our time that we will do the things in another day and next day we will think that in another next day or in next day. We should do that work finish at once, at the same day. Because if we will do the same things on the same day, we will not face any kind of problem in our life. Basically, it is a habit of some students that they did the work, they do the work, you know, not in proper way. They leave their work for tomorrow, and we know that tomorrow never comes. So we have to finish our work on the same day. We should not leave our homework, leave our daily assignment for tomorrow. Okay, so students, this is the chapter, and you guys are supposed to follow this timetable. You have to be very conscious regarding to your priorities, very conscious regarding to your studies and your daily assignment. Okay, and the same thing which I will tell you, you have to do the things according to your timetable. You should prepare the timetable for each and every subject, because some students are good in some subjects and some students are weak in some subjects. So in which subject they are weak, they should prepare a separate timetable and give spare time for their activities and their work. Okay, so now this before the ending of this chapter, I would like to write some, you know, difficult word for this chapter. Okay, and after this we will discuss some more things. So first,
hobby. You know, student, hobby, as I told you, ki an activity you do regularly. You do regularly for pleasure in free time. For priorities. The fact or condition.
So students, these are the words which you are supposed to write in your fear note. I will repeat these words from the very first. First one is hobby. Hobby means an activity which you do regularly for pleasure and free time. Second one is handful. Handful means as much of something you can hold. And the third one is scald. Scald means rebuke. And the fourth one is refuse. Refuse means deny. Fifth one is intentionally. Intentionally is here to represent deliberately. And next one is priorities. Priorities means the fact or conditions regarded as important. And last one is satisfied, which means please. Okay? So these are the words which you are supposed to follow. See student, in this chapter, there is one activity. The activity is the timetable as for you, as the Dinesh grandmother suggested. Fill it with the list of things you have to do. That in first column it is very very important. In second column weekends only, and third one is for entertainment or recreation only. You have to fill this list and write it in your fair notebook. Okay. So that's all in the chapter. Thank you.